You know what, Dwayne? I need to give you props on how not to do an introduction because seriously, this introduction looks generic, meh, bland, vanilla, whatever adjective you want to describe mediocre. Because literally though, it looks like it was done in 5 seconds on the Vista version of Windows Movie Maker. But enough about that. I know this is going to be your typical reaction as soon as you get done seeing this triple feature commentary I'm doing on you.
Hey everyone, it's me, Sailor Moon, and today I'm going to do a piss poor rant on that commentator named Juniorfan Returns in the BD-102. Sailor Moon says, I'm being controlled by a 27-year-old man-child on what words I should speak, because basically I'm not even moving my mouth.
Yeah, you're going to repeat yourself in like every other rant. So let's go ahead and get this triple feature commentary started.
Hi everyone, it's me, Sailor Mars.
Hi Dwayne, oops I meant to say Sailor Mars, which Sailor Mars must have really let herself go after the Sailor Moon franchise died out. Because seriously, Sailor Mars is telepathic, didn't anybody notice that? She gained a new ability, folks, that's the main reason why she ain't moving her mouth or moving any of her ligaments. She could talk to you with her mind, holy shit! And not only that, she let herself go with her voice, she sounds deeper, like she really has a beer belly, which she so doesn't sound like a 27-year-old man-child.
And I know Sailor Mars says that it's rare for me, but becoming very common for me to do rants on YouTube.
Oh yeah, Dwayne, I'm pretty sure that a lot of people are going to find you very intimidating, especially for the fact that you're a 27-year-old man-child that's holding a Sailor Scout doll, and the fact that you're using it as a third person in your particular rants. Yeah, people are really going to take you seriously over your pathetic rants. You know what, my best advice I would give you is to get rid of your friggin' Sailor Scout dolls, in particular rants, and not play with the damn things, and maybe show off your face. That would make your rants, I don't know, a little bit better? Maybe people would take you seriously?
I probably have done probably more rants on YouTube than Halzing920, and if you haven't seen a rant on that idiot, go check it out.
So basically, you compared yourself to an actual good ranter that actually puts effort into his friggin' videos, particularly I'm talking about Helsing920. Wow, Dwayne, I'm pretty sure he doesn't hold a fucking Sailor Scout doll like an 8-year-old trying to defend both his abusive parents and one of them's fixing to beat the crap out of another.
Anyway, Sailor Moon said, Sailor Mars said, I'm gonna make a rant on commentators who don't like our videos.
So basically you're gonna go ahead and make a piss poor and irrelevant rant on people who, I don't know, just flat out make fun of you, whether it be commentators who don't give you any constructive criticism, which I wouldn't blame them because of the certain videos that you do and the certain things that you hold up, which I'm not going to be repeating myself, and trolls who just make your emotions run wild. Okay, Dwayne, do you see the problem and illogic in this particular part of your video that I sent so far? Okay, people make fun of one another all the time onto YouTube, and the fact that you're going to make a rant that's not only going to waste your viewers' time, but also yourself, and the fact that you're also telling people that, hey, I'm trollbait, I'm here, please go ahead and troll me as much as you want, especially for people who actually see your videos for the first time, is really going to make you even more of a lolcow and basically a total idiot onto the whole entire site. Not like you were any brighter than you were before making this video.
And give us negative feedback or criticism. First off, dipshit.
Did he really say dipshit? Really? Okay, run, run! The apocalypse is coming because of how angry he sounds! Run!
Sailor Mars said, you come on here and you say that our videos are immature, inappropriate, and boring.
And refer to what I said about him playing with the Sailor Scout dolls, okay, thanks, bye.
If our videos are inappropriate, immature, or boring, why in the hell are you even watching them?
Holy shit, I sense the first signs of butthurt being awakened by this particular man-child. But seriously though, dude, people have the right to watch your particular videos if they want, and people have the right to actually commentate on the videos that they want, okay? You can't shove it down people's throat, because you're just presenting yourself even more that you're becoming extremely butthurt, and the fact that you're becoming more and more troll bait. Don't you see what you're doing, son? You're becoming the laughingstock of the internet. Because we have the right to watch your videos, kind of like you have the right to watch ours. Particularly the commentaries that you love to bitch and moan so much about.
If you're so concerned about your children, or anybody else watching our stuff, then why are you watching it?
Well, obviously, we have obsessed Sailor Moon fanboys intruding our apartments here in Linkin Park. You better hide your kids and hide your wife, as he's gonna go ahead and rape you with the Sailor Moon dolls that look like a dildo. You are so dumb. You really are.
Go watch somebody else's YouTube channel. You see, people out here on these commentators claim that our videos are immature and inappropriate.
Knowing Dwayne is basically going to be repeating himself, I'm going to go ahead and skip until I see a part where he doesn't repeat himself.
Now, another thing that you people like to do, Salomar says, because you people, the reason, see, we don't, you see, maybe we...
So I guess going ahead and not editing out the stuttering is going to make your videos more realistic, huh, Dwayne? Oh, spoiler! Also, I guess you don't realize that your subscribers and your fans and your friends are going to lose interest anytime they hear you stutter, because they want to hear your points, not you know, shit like that is what loses interest for subscribers. That will make them turn off into watching something else if you're so concerned about your subscribers and whatnot. Oh ho ho! Spoiler again!
Okay, Salomar said, you like to make fun of us for things that we say. You know, like we had a stutter attack right there, I had a little stutter attack right there. You will basically make fun of me.
Right, because you use excessive amount of pausing and stuttering in your particular videos. That's why people make fun of you, dipshit!
Yeah, seriously, you will, Salomar said, you idiot.
I come from a land of love.
Salomar said.
Also, please, just stop repeating the character's name. Of course, you're not going to take my advice, are you? But let me just say, it's extremely annoying, okay? I've been hearing Sailor Mars says this and Sailor Mars does that for 6 times over the past couple minutes, okay? We get that you're referring to yourself as Sailor Mars. What's next, dude? You're going to go out there and have a new personality for Sailor Mars? Is Sailor Mars really going to be like Geno from Super Mario RPG and gain a new personality? Jesus fucking Christ.
There is no... we don't edit that stuff out, because if we did, Sailor Mars said, we would have this messed up video. If you don't know how to use the edit feature on the editing program, and I don't care if it's Microsoft Windows Movie Maker or Apple's Macintosh iMovie,
or Sony Vegas, or Adobe Premiere, or ULEED Studio. Oops, sorry, I had to say that.
If you don't know how to use that right, you will jack up your movie, you stupid idiot.
Oh no, guys, you better watch out. He's becoming more and more of a badass because he called all of us stupid idiot. Run, run, he might actually go ahead and chase us down. But in all seriousness, though, Dwayne, do you know what jacking up a video is? How do you know it's necessarily a bad thing for someone to jack up a video? Do you even know how to edit out your videos? Of course you don't. Because really, even though you may have 3,000 videos in your particular inbox, I can tell that you do them in one sitting and that's it. And basically, you treat your videos like processed meat at a local McDonald's manufacturing plant. with no love, and that's processed very quickly. And the fact that your rants, like this one in particular, you're just shooting off your mouth, just saying, okay, it's good and it's bad, but really not giving any explanation on why the certain subject or topic or user is a good thing or bad thing. So please, just stop.
Or idiot, Say Lamar said. See, you noobs, apparently, you noobs like to single us out.
Knowing that numbnuts over here is just basically going ahead and name-calling mixed with the fact that he ain't making any points in his particular videos, I figured I would go ahead and skip until I seen another part of the video where he doesn't repeat himself.
Yeah, your videos apparently boring, Say Lamar said. Basically, all your videos are assert a still image. I don't care what it is.
Which is called the cutaway commentaries. You forgot one thing, Dwayne. You forgot the fact that people also auto-ducked in their commentaries as well.
With saying still a Bill Cosby still image.
But they've got a hand. So, while your right hand is doing this, your left hand can be doing this or, you know. But if your left hand sees how much fun your right hand is having, it won't want to be left out.
Then put a clip of one of our videos, flip back to Bill Cosby when you commentate, then switch back to our videos. So basically your videos are nothing more than still image, our stolen video, still image, our stolen video.
And refer to what I said about editing out your video as a necessary thing. Okay, thanks, bye. And by the way, dude, I'm not going to go ahead and repeat myself of what I mentioned from the RJ Bansma commentaries. Just look under this certain section of a certain right of 1976. Just look at it for a moment. It's not stolen, dipshit. It's under fair use. I didn't know that Sailor Moon Red just became the next RJ Bansma. Holy shit.
And you're going to say that your videos, your commentary videos, are more entertaining than ours? No. You're... No way. Get out of here, Salamar said.
Looks like somebody is in great denial.
If you're going to honestly say that your videos are more entertaining because you get on YouTube and flap your gums and everybody sees your face every day, get the hell out of here. Our videos are more entertaining than yours.
Time to play an appropriate song, knowing that Dwayne's videos are much better than the typical commentators who actually commentate on his videos.
My dog's bigger than your dog. My dog's faster than yours. My dog's shinier cause he gets kennel ration. My dog's better than yours.
Seriously. Some of you people out there might be partners. Some of you out there might be rental YouTubers. I really don't give a damn.
Really? I thought some of us were atheists. I thought some of us were lesbians. I thought some of us were Jewish. Hell, I thought some of us went to the local Jack in the Box and had a Big Jack burger and fries. Man, what a day we had! I know that was random and out of place, but seriously, I had to put a joke in there somewhere.
Say Lamar says. Uh-huh. Our videos are really entertaining, and that's why we got so many subscribers and friends on YouTube, yeah.
Are you shitting me? Really? People are interested in watching a 27-year-old man-child and obsessed Sailor Moon fanboy in playing with his Sailor Moon dolls, his stuffed cats, which are supposed to represent Sailor Moon's cats, Power Ranger action figures, and WWE action figures in his particular videos. Okay, the people who do indeed subscribe to you are your haters and people who subscribe to you for the lulz. And the fact that you don't even block them except for whenever they post a negative comment on your channel. Besides that, let me check to see how many views you get in your particular videos. Let me go ahead and check to see how many subscribers you have. Let me go ahead and check to see how many people you subscribe to. And let me go ahead and check to see how many friends you've got onto this particular channel. As I figured, you're nothing more than a sub-for-sub and friend whore that mainly gets people who subscribe to you mainly the haters and people who subscribe to you because you are indeed a lol cow, okay? The sub-for-sub whores, they don't care about watching your videos. No, all they care is about a subscription account or how many subscribers they got. Congratulations, Dwayne. I so need to go ahead and play you off the derp buzzard.
Derpity derp, 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 derpity derp, 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 derpity derp, 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 derp. Derp 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 derp.
And here's another thing you commentators tend to believe. You tend to say that the only reason why you got so many friend subscribers is because they go for the sub for sub stuff. They really don't watch your videos. You idiots, SailorMoonRed1 said. You idiots. You know, our videos get watched by many people. Michael Loggy, 86, T Angel Hose, Adam and Kate, Cute Chan Elty. Just name a few people. Sonic Moon 1.
That's one big motherfucking list you got right there, Dwayne. Is that seriously how many people that's actually subscribed to your account and actually watch your videos? Or is that the total amount of people that watch your videos altogether except for when you make pointless rants on people you quote-unquote don't care about, but you make them anyway, that in technicality you contradict yourself because you really do care about the people that you rant about?
Just to name a few people who actually watch our videos and leave comments on them. What do you think we do? Go around making multiple bot accounts and comment on our own videos?
Holy ass-licking, dick-sucking, douche-eating, vagina-sniffing kumquats with a side of diarrhea hot sauce! But Dwayne contradicted himself! Holy shit! Knowing Dwayne just contradicted himself by having another account where he basically plays with Godzilla toys and where he comments on his own videos that he makes on the SailorMoonRed1 account, I figured I would play off this perfect clip knowing he just contradicted himself by a lot, and trust me, he probably has other multiple accounts as well.
One contradiction! Eating another!
Get the hell out of here, SailorMoonRed1 said. Your stupidity simply amazes me.
Look who's talking, bud.
Thank you. Okay. Where was I? Anyway, SailorMoonRed1 said, if you don't, and if you're mad at that little part in the video was in there, too bad, deal with it.
No, I'm not gonna deal with it because literally, if I had to watch another second of your shitty ass rant, I literally would commit suicide, not only by drug overdose, but also from alcohol poisoning, by mixing the concoction of friggin' Nexium, or whatever prescription drug I would mix with the friggin' Budweiser and Jack Daniels, and that's how I literally would have killed myself. Because seriously, the second portion of his quote-unquote excellent rant is very repetitious. In fact, he repeats himself a lot in his particular rant on commentators. And guess what, boys and girls? He made another shit-tastic rant on commentators.
Gosh darn it!
That's right. By his own persona. Not relying on an inanimate Sailor Moon doll for him to use as a third person like what I mentioned earlier into this particular commentary. Now, I'm going to say this, that I'm only going to watch a minute of this particular rant video because, like I said, it's about as repetitious as, say, his other rants that he does on commentators. And I'm going to say this again, that his rants are very pointless, irrelevant, and a friggin' waste of time because he says that he doesn't care about what commentators say onto his friggin' videos, but he makes the goddamn things anyway, which shows hypocrisy on his part. He says he doesn't care about the particular videos, but yet at the same time, he does. What the fuck, dude? Anyway, let's go ahead and watch his message towards the commentators.
Okay, it's me, Dwayne here.
Hello, Dwayne, the person behind the still, not the person who's actually holding the Sailor Moon dolls.
Another stupid little Metcha video that I got put together because I gotta speak as myself. Now, regardless if I make this video or not, regardless, no one is gonna take it seriously.
Then why the fuck did you make this particular video?
None of the commentators will take it seriously, and I'm using a still. Now, first off, these commentators, I don't care who they are or what their names are, but apparently they tend to believe that their videos are perfect.
No, most commentators that are on YouTube, they will admit they're not perfect. They point out the obvious flaws in the particular videos, and they will do it either in a constructive manner or they will do it by just, well, simply flat out making fun of the person. Haven't I told you this before, dipshit?
Yeah, they go and say, oh, our videos are perfect because we edit out every inappropriate and immature thing, and we use stilts.
And even though I only watch 53 seconds of this particular message video out of a minute, I'm done with Dwayne when it comes to his particular rants on commentators. And as you could tell, his videos are extremely monotonous when it comes to his points. He tends to repeat himself a lot. He doesn't make any valid points. And in general, he needs to edit his videos out badly. I don't care if they are realistic. I don't care if he's too much of a lazy motherfucker. Either way, if he's so goddamn serious about his subscribers and whatnot, he needs to edit out his videos. Otherwise, people will not care about what type of videos that this particular user makes because he will lose interest of a lot of people that actually watch his videos. Anyway, this is part one of the triple feature commentary. Part two will be the final video that will be featured onto the triple feature commentary, where Dwayne explains why he doesn't go to work. So stay tuned for that. This is Juniorfan, or the BDE102. Out. For anybody that doesn't realize it, this is part two of the triple feature commentary, as part one is where I bash on him with his rants on commentators. For people who hadn't seen part one of the particular triple feature commentary, go ahead and watch it right now, because this is part two where I'll be bashing on why he doesn't want to work. So anyway, let's go ahead and get this commentary started. And I'm impressed. There's no boring text introduction at the beginning of SailorMoonRed1's video. Holy shit, this video might actually turn out half decent. Probably not.
Hi everyone, it's me, Sailor Moon.
And like usual, like a majority of his videos, he always has to rely on a friggin' doll just so he can go ahead and talk to it in a third person's perspective with the same monotone voice. Yep, that's Dwayne for you.
And today I'm making a video here to finally answer the question that a lot of our subscribers and friends have put to us or asked us.
And I wonder what that epic yet overhyped question that his fans answered would be. Could it be that they asked why he plays with the Sailor Moon dolls? Or why he doesn't have a job? It could be any of those questions. Who knows? Anyway, let's continue on with this video.
From our first YouTube channel, Sailor Moon Red, and our new YouTube channel, Sailor Moon Red 1.
Blah, blah, blah. He's just rambling along. I wonder what that question is, so let's go ahead and just skip over half of the nonsense.
Just asking him why he doesn't work or what he does for a job.
And here comes the response we want to hear from the $64,000 question!
First off, Dwayne is unemployed.
I didn't know.
Dwayne has been unemployed for about 26 years of his life.
That's one hell of an accomplishment in a career you're going for, huh, Dwayne? Just sitting on your ass and playing with those Sailor Moon dolls. Yep, I'm pretty sure that NASA or the Army is gonna hire you so that way you can become the next aerospace engineer. Oh, hell yeah! Way to go, Dwayne.
He has no desire to work. He doesn't like to work.
Holy shit, that's one hell of an excuse, Dwayne. You don't want to work. You have no desire to work. Wow, that is one hell of an excuse, Dwayne. You're not even being that specific when it comes to that part of the excuse, huh? Well, it seems to me that the main reason why you don't want to work, Dwayne, is because you got brain damage, okay? And the people that work their asses off to pay for their taxes, like the people who you live in, like the fine people of Pennsylvania, and the people here in the United States, they're basically paying you to sit on your ass all day playing with your Sailor Moon dolls. In fact, you get a Social Security check and a disability check, like, every month. So, if that's the main reason why you have no desire to work, and you have no will to work, that tells to us that you are indeed a lazy motherfucker. And the way you present yourself by playing with these Sailor Moon dolls, it looks like you are physically able to work. Okay? I doubt you even get that much for SSI or disability. So, shut up.
And the reasons is, Sailor Moon says, first off, the reason that I don't like to work, and he don't like it, is because of paying federal, state, county, and local taxes.
Let me ask you this, Dwayne. Are you an American? If you said no, then you're a fucking retard, because you live in the state of Pennsylvania, my friend. Okay, and the main reason why I say this is the fact that whether or not you get Social Security checks or disability checks, the government still takes it out of your monthly checks, like every month, for some pay. That particular pay that they take out is for taxes, okay? Whether you like it or not, the government is taking the money out to improve onto the military. Not only are they trying to improve onto the military, but also the state taxes, which are supposed to improve on the roads, the school systems, the sanitation department, whatever the case may be, to try to improve on both the state you live in and the country you live in. And I'm not going to go into great detail about taxes and whatnot, because this is not an economic course. This is a commentary. And what I'm saying, Dwayne, is that, first of all, you, as a taxpayer, you have to file for taxes, like, every year. In between the times of January all the way up till April, when you get your W-2 form, or whatever type of form you get in order to file for your taxes, okay? And whether you like it or not, you have to file for them, or else the amount that you owe will increase. And if it increases enough, that means you go to jail, or you go to the federal prison, where you sit on your ass all day, you know, wondering, okay, why the hell did I not, you know, pay my taxes, and so on and so forth. So that excuse you made, let's just say that you made yourself look even more of a fool than you were before. Thanks, asshole.
First off, how would you like it if that you're working for a living and you know that you think you're going to make this amount, but in reality you're only going to make this amount, and then you have to budget that money because you're not going to have enough left over, because a lot of it's going to go into federal, state, county, and local taxes. And then if you're lucky, the other half of it will go into utilities and other stupid things.
Let me ask you this, Dwayne. How in the name of Donald Trump's asshole is Fidelity or 401k a bad thing? Or a stupid thing, I might add. Especially for the fact of the whole entire hiring freeze that's been going on recently, and the fact that the unemployment rate has gone up significantly. Can you please answer me those simple questions? Okay? For a company or a corporation that offers 401k benefits or Fidelity benefits, that means the company is doing extremely well, and the fact that they're trying to hire more people to work for their specific industry. You, my fine friend, don't understand what 401k benefits or Fidelity benefits are, do you? They take some of the money that you make from your last paycheck. They take some of that money and they put it towards your future retirement, okay? A lot of Americans, they don't want to work past the age of 65. However, some of them do because they're bored out of their freaking mind. So, tell me, Dwayne, how the hell is Fidelity or 401k a bad thing, you Nimrod? Tell me!
And you think that, and plus, every job out there, regardless of the education required or the experience, I don't think anyone is truly happy of what they're doing.
And that I do agree with to a certain extent, Dwayne. People may not like the jobs that are offered for them. But let me just say that a lot of people appreciate the fact that they are working, even if it's part-time, I might add. People are appreciative that they're going to buy clothes for themselves, that they're going to pay part of the mortgage or rent, that they are going to pay for food for themselves. They are appreciative of paying the light bill, of the sewage, of the water bill, whatever it takes to actually provide amount of decency of where they live. Okay, if they have kids, well, they have to provide for their kids, even if both parents are divorced for child support. Okay, that's something we like to call manning up and taking responsibility for your own action.
No one really likes their job, and that's probably true. Even though you ask anyone, they'll probably tell you yes, because that's what you expect to hear, is people telling you yes. Okay? And I don't care what kind of job you have. I don't even care if you're a YouTube partner. No one can truly like what they do.
No shit, Sherlock. And thanks for repeating yourself. You don't care to edit that part of the video out, do you, numbnuts?
Tell you the truth. You get a job because you have no choice, not because you want to. I don't know too many people that willingly want to get a job. Tell you the truth. That's kind of stupid.
According to your pathetic and egotistical mind, yes, people might find it stupid for the fact they want a job. But for everybody else, they want a job for what I just mentioned, okay? Their lives are not sugar-coated. A lot of people don't have relatives of Donald Trump, Oprah, Bill Gates, Sam Walton, Gordon Ramsay, or other famous people here in the United States. You know, it's not sugar-coated. They have to fucking work. How many fucking times do I have to tell you this, Dwayne? Maybe drilling it inside your friggin' skull, maybe that'll help hinder what I have to say again and again and again. Oh, boy. And not only that, Dwayne, I imagine people are sick and tired of sitting at the house all day being bored out of their freaking minds. I wouldn't blame them. That's why people do volunteer work. That way they're not sitting on their asses all day doing absolutely nothing. Plus they're actually helping the community out that they're associated with.
And Dwayne never liked that idea. Once upon a time ago, he was stupid like everybody else.
So I guess going ahead and siphoning government taxpayer dollars for the fact that they want you to sit on your lazy ass all day, play with friggin' Sailor Moon dolls via webcam, become the humiliation of the internet, is really the way to go. Oh, that is such a smart and bold decision. Why can't anybody else figure that way? It's so not a selfish and jealous and greedy act for us Americans to do. I mean, hell, why don't we all just go on welfare? Why don't we all go ahead and do unemployment? I mean, shoot, not all of us are fucking greedy and selfish like you, Dwayne. I mean, hell, you have the ability to work. It looks like you're physically able to, like what I mentioned in this commentary. I mean, shoot, Dwayne, that was a real brilliant point you made. I have to commend you. I have to clap. Way to go, douchebag.
And I was stupid, too, and thought that, hey, getting a job would be cool, and then finding out that it's not as cool as you make it out to be. First off, if you get a job, then you're working for somebody else, and then you gotta obey to their rules.
Like a lot of things in life.
And that you have to do everything correctly.
Which is something called a requirement. The thing with it is, Dwayne, is that your parents taught you what requirements were at the age of 2, at the very latest. Because the parents told you what to do and what not to do. And if you disobeyed their orders, you would get punished. Whether they spank your behind, or whether they sit you in the corner, or whether they told you you couldn't eat dessert or watch television for a week. Okay, it's that simple. Christ.
or it's more easier to lose a job than it is to get a job.
And I'm not going to be repeating myself, just refer to what I said, okay, thanks, bye.
A lot of people think it's hard to get a job, well, mainly it's harder to keep it once you do get it. And guess what? A lot of things can go wrong, okay? Showing up on time, that's a big thing. That's a big thing, okay?
Which is something called dedication and reliability. This is a thing, Dwayne. If a person goes on time or they're earlier than their expected shift, that means the person is reliable and dedicated to their coworkers and their employer. That way, the balance of the flow of the certain work aspect isn't bothered by the person being late. If it's bothered by someone being late, then it messes up the flow of the workplace.
So no. Working is not a good thing for me, Sailor Moon said. Hell, Dwayne doesn't like it either. He never did.
And I know I'm fixing to ask this question again, like I did in the previous part of the commentary, but here we go. Dwayne, why in bloody hell do you have to rely on an inanimate doll to do your fucking bidding? Why? Especially for the fact that you're trying to explain to your viewers why you don't want to work. Okay, it just shows that you're becoming more and more of a lolcow because of this particular doll, and people are supposed to take you very seriously for the fact you don't have a job. The thing with it is, Dwayne, is that people aren't going to take you seriously because people are going to assume that this 27-year-old man-child is basically a 7-year-old trying to defend both his abusive parents by holding up a doll and saying, Mommy, Daddy, stop fighting! If people see you do that in public, people would punch you right in the fucking face.
He had to spend 15 years in his school defending his right to not work.
So it took you 15 years to come up with some lame-ass excuses of why you don't want to work. Okay, works with me, Dwayne. I mean, shoot, you really haven't explained anything yet. I mean, if it took you 15 years to think of why you didn't want to work besides the fact that you're slightly brain damaged, then, yeah, that'll work. Oh, by the way, if you've been in school for 15 years, that means you are a lazy motherfucker for 2 of those years. Because normally, when you go from elementary school all the way up to 12th grade and graduate, it takes you about 13 years to finish school entirely. So, yeah, it just shows that you're even lazier than what we expected, Dwayne. Congrats.
Because everybody else out there basically thought it was a bad idea. And I don't like to work. Yes, I have Social Security. I don't know what my Social Security account is, so don't ask me, because I don't know it, so you can't get it from me.
Oh, really? I thought you were going to show off your number for your Social Security. I mean, shoot, none of us would go to jail or federal prison for theft or larceny. I mean, shoot, that wouldn't be the case. Oh, heavens no. Please, don't put the pin on us, pal. Oh, good God. Thanks for pointing out the obvious, Captain Obvious.
Okay. I think that's pretty cool. If you don't know something, you can't get it from someone, see?
I did not realize that. Yeah. Russell, did you realize that?
No, I did not realize that.
Also, yeah, got Social Security retirement as well as Social Security disability.
Knowing this dumb fuck is basically repeating himself, I'm gonna skip ahead until I see something that's, well, slightly different from what I'm hearing, and maybe something that sounds a little bit more interesting. But I seriously doubt I'm gonna find something like that.
Now, don't ease and bring in school is not the same, okay? Dwayne went to school for 15 years and enjoyed going to school. Not because it was a federal and state obligation. No.
Do you hear yourself talk, Dwayne? Does your inadequate mind comprehend what you just said was completely and utterly fucking retarded? It should have, because going to school is a federal and state obligation, dumbass! What the fuck is wrong with you? Do you understand that most businesses that run corporations such as McDonald's and fucking Walmart and any of the places that you are willing to work, most of them require at least a GED or a high school diploma? Don't you fucking realize that, especially this day and age? Of course you don't! You make me sick with this fucking video, Dwayne, and the main reason why I'm raging is because of your fucking stupidity level, okay? I'm sick and tired of morons like you that thinks it's cool just to sit on your fucking lazy asses all day doing absolutely fucking nothing. You have the physical ability to actually work. I'm sick and tired of people like you that ruin our fucking country. So shut the fuck up!
That's not the same. Sure, Dwayne sure always got on a school bus and got at school on time. Yeah, but if he got late, we couldn't blame it on himself, now could he? Okay?
Of course, because, you know what, I'm done trying to speak common sense to this idiot. And in general, that's all I can take. So, in conclusion, what's my final thoughts on SailorMoonRed1? Well, as you can tell by the certain videos that I commentate on, the guy is an embarrassment to say the very least. His fans and his supporters, or should I say his ass-kissers because he's a friend and sub-for-sub whore, are basically mindless zombies that are controlled by this idiot. Now, this guy has indeed made rants on commentators and has made really piss-poor videos. So either way you look at it, I still don't understand how the hell this guy has over 2,000 subscribers, except for the fact that he's a sub-for-sub whore. And plus, he is an egotistical motherfucker, and really, in general, he has made me rage more in my commentaries than ever before, and he's made me say more F-bombs than I have in a long while. So trust me, this guy has definitely deserves to be on the stupid list when it comes to being onto YouTube. Yes, this guy's got brain damage, but there's no excuse for him to make shitty-ass rants like what he's been doing.